Distinguished members of the Club de Madrid, ladies and gentlemen, let me start by thanking the Club de Madrid for inviting me to join your General Assembly. I regret I'm unable to be with you in beautiful Florence, as this is quite a busy time in the international climate change negotiations. In just a few days, in Lima, Peru, governments will meet at this year's UN Climate Change Conference. They do so with wind in their sails. In New York in September of this year, record numbers of people took to the streets and internet to rally in support of action on climate change. Then, Climate Week showed businesses and investors are waking up to the risk of climate inaction and bottom line rewards of installing renewables, increasing efficiency, and greening both supply chains and operations. At the UN Secretary General's Climate Summit, more than 100 heads of state and government gathered in one room at one time to reinforce their commitment to limit warming to less than 2 degrees Celsius. And then, of course, we had the very important recent announcements of last week. This commitment to action, this incorporation of climate change into business and investment strategy, and this redoubled political will to act is indicative of a larger trend towards low carbon solutions to real problems: volatile markets, stranded assets, risk exposure, overhead costs, and unstable growth. And this trend, which is currently injecting confidence into the international climate negotiations, is due to many practical and pragmatic reasons. The falling cost of renewables, constantly evolving energy technology, need for disaster preparedness and response, and not least of which, leadership by the Club de Madrid and many more. Now is the moment to ramp up this effort and accelerate this trend as governments meet in Lima to draft a new agreement and head into 2015, when national contributions to the agreement will be announced in March and the agreement adopted in Paris in December. This is our moment, our opportunity to make the new agreement strong and durable, not just a 5-year business plan, but a blueprint that cities, countries, companies, investors, and individuals can use to bend the emissions curve this decade and build a fully climate neutral global economy this century. Now, as the architecture of an environmentally sound, equitable, and economically prosperous future is being developed, now is the moment when leadership is needed more than ever before. I therefore ask the Club de Madrid to build on the great foundation you have put in place, to do everything you can to put even more wind in the sails and move the international process forward faster towards a better future. I thank you.